clearly visible as a result of malnutrition, whose hair is so sparse that you could count the strands, who is dying slowly because they can't get the right nutrients for sustenance. Malnutrition is a tragedy in Africa, particularly in Nigeria, where many families have become displaced as a result of insurgency. Every day, 1,000 Nigerian children die of malnutrition. 2.5 million children are severely malnourished, out of which only 400,000 of them can get the therapeutic foods that are imported. The need for a sustainable solution has prompted me to start up my company, NutriHeal Integrated Concept. I am Mercy Shosonya, the founder of the company. We produce two food products. The first one is a ready-to-use therapeutic food for rehabilitating malnourished children, and it's called Chubby Meal. Sorry, next slide. It's called Chubby Meal. Yeah. Okay, we're done with this. Next slide. Chubby Meal. And then the second product is Toro Gold, which is a healthy family cereal. My ideal customers, next slide. My ideal customers are mothers of malnourished, my ideal customers are governments and donor agencies that purchase therapeutic foods for donation to malnourished children. And then mothers of, thank you. Okay, great, thank you. Now mothers of healthy children who need to save time while providing healthy foods for their children are also a very important segment of our market, because Toro Gold, the second product, provides in 5 minutes what would have ordinarily taken a mother 6 days to process and prepare. And so we combine a unique mix of ingredients in our products, and children just love the taste of our products. There are 19 manufacturers all over the world in 14 countries that produce therapeutic foods, and NutriSet has the largest market share of 60%. But because we are local in Nigeria, we can achieve a 50% market share because we are based in the region, and then we source our products locally. And then now our products cost $48 per carton, while the imported therapeutic foods cost about $66.2 per carton, and so ours is definitely cheaper. And then we are located in the region with the highest burden of malnutrition in Nigeria, so we are close to our customers. All right, thank you. Next. All right, I think I'm done with the markets. All right. Now, our team, I am Mercy Shosonya. I'm a nutritionist with more than 10 years experience in the nutrition industry, and I've been working with women and children in communities. And my partner is Wale, who builds our equipment and has been an entrepreneur for about 20 years. Now, where are we? We have our factory, our products are fully developed, and then we have our local certification from the Food and Drug Administration and Control in Nigeria. But for us to be able to market to governments and donor agencies, we will need to have an international certification. And then we also need to scale up and begin to produce and market in, on a large scale. I just want to say, I'd love to partner with you to get those products into the market so that we can help children recover from malnutrition and prevent it in the future. Thank you. Are there any questions? Sugars and oils, so ours is definitely better. And the taste is indigenous. You know, it's actually approximates the taste of a locally consumed snack, which children love very much. So that's another thing. And then our pricing, we sell $48.2 per carton, while the international one comes for $66.4 per carton. So our pricing. And then our location, we are close to where the burning is highest, so we can easily distribute our products at a low cost. And then for the Torre Gold, it's all natural. All local ingredients, all natural. There are no additives to that, so definitely it's better, more healthy.
What is the current barrier to getting these types of therapeutic foods to the children who need them? How are you going to overcome that?
Okay, basically the main barrier we have now is the international certification. So once we're able to get that, and then we're working with some partners to see how we can get the international certification, but definitely we need the funding because it's quite, you know, capital intensive to do the international certifications. So that's basically what we have. And then we need to, you know, get to do a lot of advocacy visits to the government so that they can patronize us, you know. And then we are planning to get people in the industry who can help us to do the advocacy so our products get there.
Thank you, but what I was really trying to get at is, right now, why aren't therapeutic foods getting to those children at all?
Okay.
And what are you going to do that will change the game for that?
Okay, in my presentation, I said 400,000 children are getting therapeutic foods out of 2.5 million. Okay, one of the major things is the cost of importing those products. And so the donor organizations have limited resources, so they can only do this much. All right. But then when there are local manufacturers, it's cheaper, it's easier to get, the shipping delays, shipping costs are excluded. So that's one of the basic things.